My friends, I bring you hope that in the midst of all of this morality policing, where protesters and rioters are getting released without charge, and people who are trying to defend themselves are getting arrested or called vandals, we have some good news. Missouri governor says he'd pardon St. Louis couple if they are charged for brandishing guns at protesters. Thank you, Missouri governor. You can criticize them for their improper use of weapons, but they were on their own property. A large mob of people came onto their private property, threatened them. Listen, let's have a conversation about threatening someone. You don't need to walk up to someone and scream, "I'm coming for you, I'll get you," or whatever threat. You can literally just illegally enter their property and they can feel threatened and then want to defend themselves. They had this dude, his name's Mark McCloskey, had his rifle seized by the cops. Now, I've criticized them extensively for defending the police. Nah, the cops violated your rights. Don't play these games. But I'm glad to see the governor is standing up for him. But we also have Josh Hawley himself seeks DOJ probe of St. Louis case on couple wielding guns at protesters. Hawley said any criminal prosecution against McCloskey family is legally unsound. Excellent. Now you got people standing up for these two citizens, and it is optimism all the way. You wanted good news? You like good news? So often news is just bad news. This is good news. Good news, everybody. Maybe it's not so bad. Well, we're seeing the rise of morality policing. We're seeing 52 nights of riots in Portland, the media blaming Trump and the feds. It's not all bad. Some people are standing up for citizens who would defend themselves. They didn't shoot anybody. They were on their own property. They're not going. Let me explain it very simply. The McCloskeys didn't take their guns, leave their property, go and track down Black Lives Matter, and then wave guns in their face. They're at their house eating dinner on their patio. They were in the defensive position. Let's read this story from The Hill. Missouri Governor Mike Parson, Republican, suggested on Friday that he was prepared to pardon a St. Louis couple if charges were filed against them for brandishing firearms at a group of protesters outside their home. Speaking on the Mark Cox Morning Show in St. Louis, Parson was asked about the investigation Circuit County Kim Gardner launched into Mark and Patricia McCloskey. The two were seen in widely shared video. We know what happened. The McCloskeys claimed in a police report that they felt threatened by the demonstrators and feared they would assault them or destroy their property. But Gardner said that she would look into the events, noting at the outset of her probe that we will not tolerate the use of force against those exercising their First Amendment rights. Well, they didn't use any force, so congratulations. Parson strongly pushed back against the impetus for the investigation, saying the McCloskeys did what they legally should do. A mob does not have the right to charge your property. They had every right to protect themselves. Hear, hear, good sir. Mark Parson, good man. Well, I don't know anything about the guy. Maybe he's not a good person, but at least here he's on the right. He's saying the right thing, so I'll agree with him. Asked whether he would consider a pardon if charges were filed, Parson said, "I think that's exactly what would happen. Hear, hear. Right now, that's what I feel. You don't know until you hear all the facts, but right now, if this is all about going after them for doing a lawful act, then yeah. If that scenario ever happened, I don't think they're going to spend any time in jail. We will not allow law-abiding citizens to be targeted for exercising their constitutional rights," Parson added in a tweet, linking to his comments. The McCloskeys first gained widespread attention in late June after a video captured the two pointing firearms at protesters who had been marching past their residence on the way to the home of St. Louis Mayor Lyda Crewson to demand she resign after she read aloud activists' personal information on a live stream. The couple told St. Louis police that the protesters trespassed on a private street and that they were in fear for their lives. A protest leader has disputed their claims, saying that the gate to the street was open and that demonstrators were peaceful. Gardner's investigation of the events has attracted intense criticism from Republican officials, including Josh Hawley and President Trump. In an interview last week, Trump claimed the investigation was a disgrace and that the couple had the right to protect their property. Parsons also noted that he discussed the matter with Trump and ways the president could potentially intervene. The next point they bring up is Josh Hawley. See, Josh Hawley actually stood up a few days ago to defend the McCloskeys. According to Fox News, they say, Missouri GOP Senator Josh Hawley on Thursday claimed the St. Louis Circuit Attorney's Office is improperly targeting the couple who wielded guns at protesters in their gated community last month and requested the Justice Department open an investigation into the case. In a letter to Attorney General Bill Barr, Hawley called for a federal civil rights probe into St. Louis Circuit Attorney Kim Gardner's investigation into the McCloskey family for using firearms to defend themselves and their property against protesters, saying, quote, "This is an unacceptable abuse of power and threat to the Second Amendment, and I urge you to consider a federal civil rights investigation into the St. Louis Circuit Attorney's office to determine whether this investigation and impending prosecution violates this family's constitutional rights," Hawley wrote to Barr on Thursday. I gotta say, man, there are very few people who have actually actively stood up for the American people in many ways, and Josh Hawley is one of them, not just on this issue, but on the issue of freedom of speech and constitutional rights. Hawley is fairly active. Look, man, how many politicians can you name that have come out and defended individuals' civil liberties? I mean, very few. Often you'll hear about people talking about broad policy positions and ideas, the right to do this, the right to do that, but will they actively call out injustice targeting people? Very few, to be honest. Josh Hawley is actually doing that. He says, "There is no question under Missouri law that McCloskeys had the right to own and use their firearms to protect themselves from threatened violence, and that any criminal prosecution of these actions is legally unsound. The only possible motivation for the investigation, then, is a politically motivated attempt to punish this family for exercising their Second Amendment rights. I think it has more to do with defying a Black Lives Matter protest." You see, in New York, Bill de Blasio was asked about, you know, public gatherings. He said, no public gatherings. What about Black Lives Matter? Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Black Lives Matter, that's okay. So what do we get? I assure you there are probably dozens of stories across this country, because it's a massive country of hundreds of millions of people, where someone pulled out a weapon to defend themselves and nobody cares. We don't hear about it because it wasn't Black Lives Matter. It's a newsworthy subject. These people came out to defend themselves. I'm pretty sure there's going to be a story about like Idaho or something, and someone came on someone's property, pulled out a weapon, and nobody will care. It might make local news. It probably wouldn't even do that. It probably happens every single day and nobody cares. Somebody walks on someone's property. They say they have some words with each other. And then one person says, you know, I'm armed and get off my property. And they do. Here in St. Louis, however, you had a very large protest group and the videos went viral, and thus they went and targeted the family. They say Hawley's attempted intervention comes after police served a search warrant at the McCloskeys' home in the upscale Central West End neighborhood of St. Louis, in the same area where the city's Democratic mayor lives. Take a look at this image. I'm not happy with it. They took the McCloskeys' rifle. The cops violated their Second Amendment rights. Josh Hawley points it out. The governor points it out. And these cops, with a smile on their face, of course I'm exaggerating, just came and took it. Just came and took their weapon. They did nothing illegal. Why? And why don't the McCloskeys call them out? Well, they didn't want to be there. No, I'm sorry, man. Saying you're just following orders is no excuse for violating someone's rights. I get it. They didn't haul off the McCloskeys to jail or anything, but they took their weapon and they have a right to bear that weapon. But the police will just do it. Same thing in New York City. They mentioned what happened. You know, the protesters came. Police seized the rifle that Mark was holding in the now viral video of the incident, while the handgun that Patricia was holding was turned over to the St. Louis police Saturday by the couple's attorney. The handgun had been in Watkins' possession as evidence that it was inoperable when she pointed it at protesters in defense of themselves and their home at the time. I don't think that matters, honestly, though, whether it's operable or inoperable. It might. Earlier this week, Mike Parson said he spoke with President Trump on the matter, and that we talked about. This is optimism. I'm sorry. This is an optimistic story. It's a positive story. You should leave this feeling better about everything that's going on. I have been very concerned with the morality policing that we've seen, or I should say it is disconcerting to see the morality policing, people getting cut loose. In Portland, a dude who was who bragged about committing arson, let go. People who defend themselves are the ones who get in trouble. That's scary reality, man. I've talked to people about it and I've said, look at these stories, man. They're coming after these people if you defend yourself. Well, that's crazy. Because what, are you supposed to just lie back and let the mob trash your house, burn it down, and kill you? No. We need to stand up for our rights. We need to speak up. The McCloskeys need to speak louder, but good on Josh Hawley and good on the governor for standing up for them. That, I think, is fantastic. But look, man, around the country, there are bad things happening. There will be people who will have your back if you do the right thing and call out injustice and a violation of civil rights. But if you do nothing, the future will just get worse. And it'll get worse for your family. It'll get worse for your friends. But worst of all, it'll get worse for your kids. So think about what you're leaving behind. The far left has an advantage, and many of these people just don't have kids. okay? But if you do, you definitely need to speak up. Because if you don't, you know what's going to happen. The mob will eventually show up for you. No amount of putting your head down will keep you safe. They will come to your house the same as they did to McCloskeys, who probably had no idea this was going to happen to them. They were sitting on their patio having dinner. They didn't think a mob was going to show up. And then there it is. I wonder how much they've spoken up. I wonder if before this they called out the injustice they saw, or if they just kept their heads down. And now they find themselves in the fray. Look, you could be the McCloskeys next. The protest might come to your neighborhood. I heard helicopters around my house last month. The helicopter in the square, they crossed the bridge. People were freaking out. They shut the bridges down next time. It may come to your neighborhood too. And if you don't join, speak up, at least in defense, well then don't be surprised if no one speaks up for you. But I'll wrap it up there and just say this. This is good news, all right? It's good news. This is cause for optimism. So I'll leave it there. Next segment's coming up in a few minutes, and I will see you all shortly.